One of the many things I wish I learned way earlier when I first started producing was all about sidechain compression. Why? Because it does so much to your mix, makes your drums stand out, makes your basses pulse pump. It cleans up your mix and it gives things room to breathe in the track. The earliest example I can think of is Daft Punk's One More Time. With that, you can hear like the vocals and the samples duck in time with the kick. Sidechain compression is all about ducking something when something else is playing. Very vague explanation, but to look at it visually, see, we have a kick drum here and we have our bass here, and this is the result of sidechain compression. The volume ducks, then builds back up right when the kick is happening. And now let's look under the hood at what sidechain compression is all about. See the gain reduction bar in orange? That is how much compression we are applying to this bass that is being triggered by this kick. Otherwise, if we didn't have the sidechain, it'd sound a little bit not as punchy. It's just two things clashing at the same time. We want more movement, we want more bounce. This is gonna give it the bounce.
The bounce coming up.
First things first, you're gonna need a compressor. And load this on your bass track or whatever else you want to duck in relation to a kick for the time being, but we'll go into some more heavy duty sidechain applications later on. First things first, click this down arrow, which will open up the sidechain module. Next thing, click sidechain audio from. This is where you're gonna set up your trigger and what will compress the compressor and give you that sidechain sound. So we're gonna go ahead and select our kick. You can start to see it come through a little bit. Nothing's really gonna happen until we drop the threshold. Sidechaining is fundamentally as simple as that. We can now dial in our exact sidechain settings. Ratio is how much it's going to compress. So 2:1 means for every 2 decibels, only 1 is going to get through. Infinite to 1 is banging. Honestly, it depends how hard you like your sidechain. I'm all for like 6 to infinite, just because I like that hardier, edgier sound. And then I'll tweak the attack and release after to give it like a sharper execution, I don't know. For now, let's go 8:1. It's still a bit laggy, still a bit late. We can drop our attack to a quicker value. When you tweak your attack and release, you run the risk of it clicking and it not sounding good. I'll give you an example. The compressor just does not like that. So always try to set your attack at like a few milliseconds and your release. Well, you can hear what the release is gonna do. It's kind of like how late you want the tail end of the pump to come through. And with the threshold, we're letting a lot of that kick come through and compress it. It's not really till like the end of the kick here where the compressor will ease up and it'll just not compress it. So that's a bit too much, so. Cool, now I'm sick of hearing the same sawtooth bass anyway. Let's go into something grittier. For example, this serum preset from our Bass House Pack Medallion. Missing the pump, missing the pulse, load up the compressor. Down arrow, sidechain, gonna input this from our kick, up the ratio, and drop the threshold. Values aren't quite there yet, we want a sharper attack sound so we get a punchier sidechain. Let's hear it by itself. Now, what we also could do is take our sidechain trigger from something completely different. For example, I have the same kick drum here, but I've sharpened up the tail of it just by using like a fade tool, like that. I've put it on a separate channel and I've muted the separate channel so the audio of this kick isn't coming through, especially if we mute this. And now you can start to hear where I'm going with this. The sidechain is still playing, but our kick over here is muted. This is kind of what we're gonna replicate with our ghost kick over here. So we're gonna change our audio from our kick to our ghost kick. And so whenever this plays, it will trigger our sidechain. So. We can play it as frequently or infrequently as we want. And the beauty of using like a ghost trigger is our kick drum is free to do whatever it wants. We have a fast bit like do-do right here with our kick drum, but we don't necessarily want our sidechain to come through like that. The ghost kick will allow us to separate our sidechain from our kick drum, for example. Something different? If you feel like getting fancy with your ghost trigger sidechain, that's an option for you. All right, let's move on to some heavier shit. As you can see, we have a much more denser Ableton project file here. There's many, many elements going along, and it is dubstep. So essentially we want our bass to duck in time with our kick and our snare. I have this setup right here. Actually, let's bump that up. I don't know what I was thinking there. And it's starting to sound like this. Got some serious ducking happening right here, and if we didn't have it, like, it's cool, but it's not quite hitting hard enough, so that's where sidechain comes in. Now, you're not just limited to one sidechain, like the ghost sidechain or a kick. You can have kick, snare. You can even sidechain it from your toms if you want. And typically for dubstep, I use infinite to one ratio of both kick and snare. So it is no holds barred. It is dropping its volume quick. Infinite to one ratio, heavy dubstep track, sidechaining from kick and snare. Let's move on to D&B. Now, sometimes you don't want to compress and squish your sounds, you just want to duck the volume. So it's not really sidechain compression anymore, it's more sidechain. But for this instance, we have our bass channel right here, and I've loaded up a utility, which looks just like this. And then what I've gone ahead and done is created my own sidechain using volume automation. Whenever the kick comes in, it's going to drop in volume by 9.8 dB. And then let the kick pass and go back to normal 0 dB. This way with sidechaining, you're getting way more control. You're not squishing your sound, you're just dropping it by volume. It's a little bit more cleaner. It sounds like this. It's not as aggressive as dubstep. We don't want the kick and the snare absolutely just blocking out our bass. We want a little bit more technical. We just want to duck it in volume just a little bit. It is a bit more time consuming than dropping in a compressor and then tweaking a few values. You have to copy and paste a lot of automation, especially for like a fast paced drum and bass track like this. All right, missing the punch. If you are unfamiliar with like creating automation like this, I will show you, for example, drag in a utility, clip the gain. The reason why we don't want to automate our volume parameter over here is, what if we want to change it at some point? Kind of just slightly annoying. By having a utility and automating this gain, it's a separate thing, so it works separately. We'll click our gain. Red dotted line will come up. We'll check our low kick. It's coming in for that long, so click here, click here, click here, drag and drop. Say the kick drum's like coming in for that long, that starts to ease up there. So maybe holding option or alt, we can change the curve just a little bit there. Depends how technical you want to get with like crafting it around your kick drum or whatever else you want to trigger it from. But that is going to be our main thing there. Then we'll copy and paste it whenever the kick drum plays. See how the sounds. Sounds all right, it's ducking a little bit too much, so we can go ahead and tweak this. I think what I had before, that 9 value was good. Punchy again. Sweet. And lastly, if you want to get even more technical and more hands-on, you can always load up the multiband compressor. Gritty glitch hop here. We have our sidechain from our kick and our snare. Sounds cool, both the compressors are getting squished when the kick and the snare comes into play. What if you want something a bit more crazy? Multiband sidechain compression. Separate out the high end, the mid end, and the low end. It's way more subtle this way, it's not the super bounce way that it was before, and we can separate it out into bass. Because one of the reasons why we use sidechain, apart from the fact that it sounds great, is because our bass frequencies clash with our kick drum frequencies. So we want to duck the bass volume whenever the kick comes in, so the kick has more room. But at the same time, the kick drum really doesn't have that much high end. So why would you want to squish your high end loads when the kick isn't occupying that much high end? So with multiband sidechain compression, we can set our high end to not compress that much, and our low end to compress heaps when the kick comes through. So. It sounds clean without too much pump. In order to do this, multiband dynamics, and treat each one of these bands as a separate sidechain compressor. But of course, we want to set this up with our kick. nothing's coming through, I'm gonna have to tweak those values. This is our ratio. When it goes to like a brown value, it's a compressor. When it goes to like a blue value, it's an expander. We want compression. So we're just gonna set these for, no, it's not going finite to one. We'll get close to that for the bass. Do, 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 and this is our threshold. So with this blue bar here for our low band, you can really see when the kick's coming through. We can also change this from RMS to peak if we want a little bit sharper sound, or RMS if we want a slow moving sound. It'll take the average instead of the peak. And time values, remember our time values from way back with our shitty saw wave. So quite quick values all round. Let's go extreme so you can kind of hear it a bit more. That is a technical and punchy sidechain. Let's hear it in action. Drop the bass just a little bit more. Of course, that's just our kick. We can load it from our snare as well. We don't want that much low end. I want a bit of mid-range because that's where our snare pops through. And a little bit high, and we can kind of leave that. So I've got our multiband sidechain. Let's hear it against our normal sidechain. Cool. I think our OG sidechain compression has more groove, but our multiband dynamic sidechain, I think it's like a cleaner, more direct mix down. It's not just squishing the shadow out, it's only squishing certain parts at certain times, so it's gonna sound a bit more technical. With Ableton, you can also sidechain from a filter, which is quite cool. I won't dive into that. Sounds a little bit wacky, but I feel like we've covered heaps of avenues of sidechaining in this tutorial, so I might just leave that one. And that, my friends, is sidechaining in a nutshell. Hopefully you did learn heaps. Subscribe if you're new around here. Have a great day and peace.